Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. What you going to do when you're back against
us? Yes. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, hallelujah. Yes, God.
This is a journey, and sometimes we just have to stop on that journey
yes.
and just inhale, exhale, and say, Lord, I thank you.
Lord, I thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
That's it.
I thank you. As
That's
we
it.
Go forth
Absolutely.
With our sister circle,
yeah, yeah.
we thank everybody that has tuned in with us today.
Absolutely.
And, you know, today is an interesting yeah. day because this evening, our talk show, we're going to kind of shift a little mm-hmm. bit. Because our objective always with our Sister Empowering Sisters Sister Circle talk mm-hmm. show is to empower, to yeah. inspire,
yes.
to
yes.
world
yes.
to become better.
Absolutely. Yes.
That's it.
Absolutely.
That's it. And
Absolutely.
So by giving the world an awakening,
yeah.
and so what we want to do, we want to give an awakening, but we want to take a shift.
Yeah.
Because we want to kind of deal with the youth tonight.
Yes. yes.
And I think that we need to take our time and deal with Generation
yes,
Judah.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Because
absolutely.
I do believe that even in observation, even as I go forth, even if I, you know, listen to parents, doing counseling, just doing talking, and just having an opportunity to connect
yeah.
with people on a daily basis, I realize that we have some issues that's
mm-hmm.
going on with
yeah,
media.
Yes.
And we want to take control of
yeah.
media now.
Right.
And we kind of want tonight, we want to expose
yeah.
the enemy.
Yes.
We want to,
yeah.
there's a media, I think there's an enemy that is trying to destroy our
yes,
youth
absolutely.
And media. And
absolutely.
I think we need to expose this tonight.
Absolutely.
I really do.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
if we don't stop to make an attempt
mm-hmm.
to expose this enemy,
mm-hmm.
it has the potential
yeah.
to really destroy our youth.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's
absolutely.
What we want to do. And we want to make this shift, and we want to talk about it. We want to kind of go deep tonight. And I believe that there are some serious issues that
mm-hmm.
we want to talk about. And that's
mm-hmm.
one of the reasons why we want to invite Sister Makisha onto the show. Come
mm-hmm.
on, give it up for her.
Yes.
And when Makisha Lion of Duty and what she does every day, I think it would be robbery not
mm-hmm.
to have her here because there's a lot of things that, even when you and I talk,
mm-hmm.
and we have opportunity to bounce back on each other. You know, Elder Kara
mm-hmm.
and I, we have kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Kara,
mm-hmm.
we've had kids. Kara,
mm-hmm.
kids are grown.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm, right now, I'm
yes.
embracing that teenage
yes.
years. And right now, even if you go back in time, Elder Kara, you can think about,
mm-hmm.
there are a lot of issues. You can see a shift in media,
mm-hmm.
things that you really never dealt with
okay,
with your
absolutely.
Kids.
Absolutely.
So you know there has been a shift.
Oh, yes.
And
yes.
so now, it's like, with parents, we need an awakening.
Yes.
Quick.
Oh,
and
yes.
so when we talk, Makisha and I, we begin to talk about all these different things that's attacking
mm-hmm.
the media. It's quite interesting, some of the things that Makisha have kind of brought to my attention and I never really thought
mm-hmm.
about. And one of the things that we deal with and we talk about a lot is that cell phone.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
And that cell phone,
yeah.
that is the root
yes.
of a lot of things
yes.
right now
yes.
that's really
yes.
taking
yeah.
control of
right.
our youth.
Yes.
And it's time for us to take back.
Yes. Yes.
Take back the things that has the potential
yeah.
to destroy you.
Absolutely.
And so that's going to take, I believe, that the parents
yeah.
have to come into a season. We have to shift our
mm-hmm.
mindset.
Yes. Absolutely.
We have to shift our mindset. And we can't casually do what we used to do
yeah.
in our former years.
Yeah, sit back.
We have to do things differently.
Yeah.
And even in your line of duties, I want you to share a little bit about some of the things that you have really experienced and some of the things that you have really seen.
Mm-hmm.
that has actually happened
mm-hmm.
because you have the opportunity to do a lot of one-on-one counseling with parents and, you know, do a lot of, you know, visits, home visits
yes.
and things like that. Tell me some of the things that you have experienced.
Some of the major things, I think all of them are major
right.
things that are going on, but what I'm finding with a lot of the homes and different situations that I visit dealing with teenagers, a lot of the parents, they're just unaware. They just don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And you really don't know what you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And the way that I look at it, the beast is literally sleeping in your house, and you have no idea.
Mm-hmm.
And what a lot of parents think about, you put an alarm on your house to keep the perpetrators from coming
mm-hmm.
inside,
wow.
but you don't understand that the perpetrators are already inside,
yes.
has already gained access
yes.
to your 7, 8, 9, 10-year-olds,
mm-hmm.
11, 12, 13, 14, 15-year-olds
yeah.
through the cell phone.
Right.
So that's what I'm finding, that a lot of parents are literally sleep at the wheel,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of kids are at the disposal of the enemy right now. And some of the major issues that we're finding is a lot of these kids, they have access to everything.
Yeah.
Through the cell phone.
Through the cell phone.
And when I say everything, I mean everything. Pornography. Yeah. You have a lot of kids that are, you know, looking at pornography, and the parents are sitting in the room or in the kitchen cooking, doing whatever they do, and have no idea the 10, 11, 12-year-old is hooked on pornography.
Wow.
So those are just some of the things, but just imagine, you know, our kids being pure, you know, they come into this world so pure, and we put a cell phone in their hand 5, 6, 7 years old. Why?
Yeah.
And then one thing, you know, I'll ask some of the parents, well, why do this child need a cell phone? Yeah. And a lot of parents, they give excuses. A lot of parents want to be the cool parent. They want to be the friend. They want to be this, they want to be that. You have a lot of parents that say, well, I can't get in touch with her.
Right.
She's at an elementary school. What do you mean you can't get in touch with her? How do they get in touch with, you know, with us when we was in school? They call the school.
Yeah, absolutely.
So you have a lot of parents that just want to, you know, be the friend instead of just putting your foot down and saying, no, I'm going to raise you. And in me raising you, in me putting in the time to raise you, it is going to hurt. But at the end of the day, I'm saving your life. And, so you know, so you have a lot of issues. Yeah. It just goes on and on because you have a lot of the issues dealing with bullying. So this can go on and on. You know, parents don't know that their kids are being bullied.
Yeah.
Through a cell phone. Wow. You know, cyber bullying.
Yeah.
And the parent come home and they find their child hanging in the bedroom. So there's some serious issues that we're having with the youth. And like I said, a lot of parents sleep at the wheel. So this right here is needed because I think that when we can come and educate the parents,
and that's what we want to
do. They know what to do. Now they have some things, you know, they have some issues and they have a conversation they can start having with these kids to say, whoa, I didn't know that.
It's being aware. And it's like, you know, what you said when you first got started, when you were saying, you know, we have to take control. We have to control social media, because if we don't control social media is going to control our youth.
Absolutely.
You know, and it's all about awareness. And I think to your point, what you're saying is that a lot of parents are using the, they're saying, well, I have to get in touch with my child, forgetting what we did back in the day. But I think what's happening today, and it's not even just with that, today, period, everything is about convenience. No one wants to put in the work anymore.
Right.
Shortcuts to life.
Yes.
It's all about shortcuts. Absolutely. You know, I mean, yeah, sure, I could call the school and the teacher can get to them, but oh, it's so much convenient if I could just call her and she picks up the phone.
Absolutely.
Everything today in today's society, we want convenience.
Yeah.
We want it fast. We want it quick. And we have to understand that when we open up the floodgates of technology, to give people what they want when it comes to convenience, we are literally opening up the floodgate of the enemy to come through, and we are allowing it.
Yes.
When all we need to do is get back to what we did in the day. Put in the work.
Yes.
That's true.
It takes the chore. Call the school. Talk to the teacher. Get a hold of your child. Honestly, how many times during the school day do you really need to get a hold of your child?
Yes,
if
absolutely.
They're in school to study, it should not be. You know,
yes.
So we have to understand again, is that about convenience for the child or convenience for us as a parent?
That's so true.
So we've got to take that off and we've got to do what's right.
Absolutely.
Because they don't understand.
Absolutely.
And you're putting that at their fingertips.
Yes.
An 8, 9, 10-year-old child having a cell phone, honestly. And we're not here to tell anybody how to raise their child, but we're simply making you aware. I watched yesterday, when was it? I think Thursday, getting dressed for work. And there was a segment on the Today Show, and they were talking about these apps that are on these phones now for these little kids.
Yes. Right.
These are applications that they can actually use, and adults are using these applications to communicate with your children because it's over the internet.
Yes.
And they were saying why they're fighting it.
Yes.
Even through Facebook now. Kids can have an account on Facebook now. Well, remember back in the day, you couldn't.
Yes. Absolutely.
I remember when social media first started, you had to be in college to have a page on social media.
Yes.
But that's gone now because
now.
Of demand, because of the money,
absolutely.
Because of what's happening in society, and it's all about the dollar. We got to quit feeding this.
Absolutely.
And we've got to put the focus on the well-being of our children and not on what's convenient
absolutely.
Or what's cool or what's hip.
And how do we separate ourselves?
How do we separate ourselves?
How do we separate ourselves from that? Because a lot of times I feel as though that we want to give our kids these tools, because if we don't give them to them, some kind of way we neglecting them.
Right.
I don't know if that makes any sense. So we find like, because everyone has one, there's a form of neglect. Well, my child don't have an iPhone or Android, there's neglect, because that's the coolest thing on the market now. So when my child don't have this thing, some type of way of neglecting them.
Right.
And I think it's, once again, it goes back to our mindset and how we have to change, even as a parent for me.
Absolutely.
You know, and I think it was something very interesting that you said, Makisha, about instead of looking at this as a tool of convenience, look at this as a weapon. And we don't look at this cell phone, that this is a weapon. This is a weapon that you're putting in your child's hand, because until they're taught how to use it properly, it's a weapon.
That's true.
And weapons can harm you. And I think a lot of times when we begin to shift and think about things differently, we have the opportunity to save our children's life. And that's really what we want to do. And when we come, kind of click off this show, we want every parent to look at that cell phone differently.
Yes.
Because right now, there's no time with it. There's no discipline with it. No restriction, no time. It's like you get the phone, you can sleep with it, you can have it anytime you want to. That's a weapon.
Yes.
And it's destroying our children because it's exposing them to things that they're not ready to handle.
And it's not the parent introducing them to it when it's time. You know, back in the day when you were, what, 16, 17, 18 years old or whatever, your parents sat you down and had the talk.
Absolutely.
Where they were introducing you, or they're letting you know about the things, the birds and the bees or what have you. You're about to become an adult. Now, these are the things that you are to expect, because certain experiences you're going to have. And when you have them, I want it to be beautiful. I want you to be ready for it. Well, guess what? Now, social media is having those conversations with our children.
Absolutely.
And not in a safe environment.
Yes.
Not in a way where they're sitting them down where they can answer questions. It's bow. It's just pow, live and in color. Raw, if you will.
And
that's what they're seeing.
Yeah.
And you know what I noticed? I just had an experience a few days ago. And one thing I noticed is that when we educate the parent, we also have to take the time to educate the child.
Absolutely.
Because if you think about it,
the
parent cannot be with that child 24 hours
a day.
So now it's like a new thing that I started when I speak to kids, I say, you are your first line of defense. Mm-hmm. What do I mean when I tell you are your first line of defense? That means we want to learn how to take safety precautions.
Yes.
Because we're not going to be around mom and dad, auntie, grandma,
always.
24 hours a day. So you know what? Let me put some real life situations in your face so you can start seeing that this thing is a tool.
Right.
Okay, how do I put some real life situations in your face? Okay, let's talk about some real issues that happen with kids that use this the wrong way, the cell phone the wrong way. And when I began to give this young girl at the age of 11, I began to give her real life stories, things that happened to young girls her age who misused the cell phone that was given to them.
I think that's powerful. I want to ask you a question, because it's funny that she's saying this, because we want to talk about the beginning. So let's crack the case from the beginning. How did this start? How did the issue really start? So when I'm thinking about what Makisha is saying, it started because we hand the tools to the kids. We hand these phones to the kids, these weapons, but we don't sit down and educate them. So that was my question. So these are the things that we need to do. Parents, you need to educate. And I think that's so powerful. I never thought about that. I don't know if you did or not.
And think about it. When you put a weapon in someone's hand, what's the first thing you do? You teach them how to use it. Let's go to the range. Let me show you how to fire. Let me show you this weapon. Let me show you what the safety is. Let me show you what to do. Let me show you what can harm you. And this is a weapon as well. But who's putting it in their hands and sitting them down and saying, okay, let me show you how to use this phone. Let me show you the sites that you don't go to. Let me show you the bad parts
of
this
that
can
ruin you. And I feel like most of the time, y'all don't care what gets the phones, and we have to put parental control on
it.
That's right.
And
I was going to say that because
we hand it over, and we go, happy birthday, Merry Christmas, no parental control. You have this weapon, and kids are super smart. And when it comes to technology, let the truth be told. They can handle that technology
better than we can.
So we're not talking about educate in terms of how to use it. We're talking about educate in terms of what's on there.
The
dangers of it, because let the truth be told, they can utilize that.
And when you hit them with reality of the dangers, and you open up their young minds to say, whoa, that can happen to me, because I've done that before. When you educate them, what I noticed in this young, she began to wake up and she began to say, oh my goodness.
She had a wild moment.
Did that really happen? I said, yeah, the little girl lost her life. because of what she did on the cell phone.
Absolutely.
And she could not believe it. She was like, whoa, that can happen to me.
So how can a child lose their life? It's interesting that you said that. How can a child lose their life with social media?
Dealing with social media.
Easily. Interacting with grown-ups. Like you know, you mentioned before, they're not just interacting with kids. And there are so many stories in the news. One happened here in Broward County. I don't know, about 2 years ago, when a young male, a juvenile, thought that he was communicating with a female on the phone. Mm-hmm. And they set him up, and this kid almost lost his life. Again, they, you know, some guys took him, and it's almost like they was getting ready to kill him. This mm-hmm. is what his testimony was, but he jumped out of the car. He must have been like 17, 18, locally wow. here.
Yeah.
He jumped. It was all over Facebook, but he managed to jump out of the car. But what was he doing? He met a girl on social media, mm-hmm. and he was planning on meeting up with her.
So it's not about age. It's not about immaturity.
It's just safety.
Yeah. Even with a child 18, 19 years old, they need to be aware of what's going on.
Yeah. I think that's good.
Absolutely.
And then you have 11 and 12 year old story where this girl is communicating with a guy that she met online. The guy's like 19, 20 years old. And he actually gets her to meet up with him. Again, she's supposed to be in school. She's a good girl. She's supposed to be in school, but she sneak out. She do what kids do. They sneak.
Right.
But think about it, if we can educate these girls and say, hey, you're your first line of defense.
Yes.
You have to make your own decision because mom and dad's not going to be there. So it's constantly in your face. I'm my first line of defense.
Yeah.
If I lose my life, it's my fault, not mom and dad's fault. Because they just educated me on the best decision to make.
That's right.
I am my first line.
Like, I can lose my life if I go meet up with him right now.
Because
I remember what I just discussed. I remember the stories that I just saw, the other girls that lost their life. So it kind of like puts the real deal in front of
them. I think that's so powerful. I never thought about it like that. I am my first line of defense. Not my parents.
Not my parents.
Even at 12 years old.
Because I could get my friend's cell phone at school. Mom took my phone.
Yeah.
I have access to your phone when I come to school.
Yeah.
What's stopping me?
Yeah.
My first line of defense is
stopping
me now.
And like you said, mom and dad can't go to school with me.
They can only go so far.
I'm only going to see them when I'm at home with them.
Absolutely.
Or when I'm in their presence. But other than that, I've got to be able to make those decisions for myself on my own.
Yes.
And that's when it comes to teaching our children that independence and making them aware. Educating them on what's out there in the world. We've got to start back, getting back to, you know, long time ago, we had this thing with small kids, toddlers.
Mm-hmm.
All of us have done it. With our toddlers, we teach them, don't speak to strangers.
Yeah.
We train them up with that. Mm-hmm. I did it with my kids.
Right.
But what about when they become older, when they become 10, 11, 12, and teenagers? Do we sit them down again and say, don't have a conversation with strangers? Listen, you have this phone that I gave you because I need to contact you.
Absolutely.
But I'm going to have to trust you.
Mm-hmm.
Don't have conversations with strangers on this phone. Don't be on Instagram and all these places. Just because you see a profile with someone and they want to talk to you, that may not be the person that you're talking to. Because people will befriend you to bait you in, to hurt you, to kill you.
Yes.
And we got to have those conversations all over again with the teenagers, because now it's not about just a stranger passing by your child in the grocery store and trying to lure them with candy. You got somebody trying to lure your teenager with technology.
And that's
so what have you educated them on?
Absolutely. Yeah. And I think what's more amazing to me is that I find out so many parents are asleep.
Yeah. Yes.
That's a heartbreaking part. Right. So many parents are asleep.
Yes.
And we have this beast in our home, you know, that's literally growing in our home, and we're not aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
We're asleep.
Yeah.
And so it's time for parents to wake up.
Yes.
Because we have to kill this potential enemy.
Yes.
And in some homes, it has become an enemy.
Yes.
We have to bring that, you know, to halt and kill it so that our children have the chance to live.
Yes.
You know, a good, fruitful life. And I think that's very important, because this generation, it's being ran by technology.
Yes, it is.
And
I
don't care how we want to avoid that, and we can pretend it doesn't exist, but this generation is being ran totally by technology. and social media. Mm-hmm. Yes, and it's time for us to wake up.
Oh, yes.
And it's time for us to begin to make sure that parental control is on these cell phones. Yes. It is time for us parents,
that's
wake
good.
Up.
That's
we
good.
Need to take control of our teenagers. Yeah.
We do it with cable, don't we?
Yeah. Absolutely.
When we get cable in our homes, those good parents, I did it with my cable.
Absolutely.
When my boys mm-hmm. were, when Absolutely. They were younger, when they were teenagers, they're adults now. But when I brought cable in
Absolutely.
My home, I put the parental
yes.
Control on cable. So there were certain channels my kids could not go to.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, but and you're bringing up a good point because, and it's just like when you talk about sin and we talk about little sins and big sins, we are so focused on the big stuff that the little stuff slides
yes.
by. You
That's
know,
it.
We put
That's
a cable it. In our home, the first thing we think about is pornography on
yes.
TV.
But can I ask a question? Why do we stop disciplining our teenagers? This is the problem yeah. we're having. It's not, you know, about our 12-year-olds. It's about mm-hmm. not just adolescents. We're talking about these kids mm-hmm. are 16, 17 years old. Mm-hmm.
18.
Mm-hmm. There's no discipline.
Yeah.
And there's no, you know, mm-hmm. time management mm-hmm. going on. You know, we just give them these phones and go, hey, there you go.
Mm-hmm.
With no type of forming any type of discipline with that.
And
I don't get that.
I think a lot of parents feel like if their child is happy with them, then they're a good parent.
Yeah.
A lot of parents don't want to be on
that.
Yeah, they don't want to be on that.
Absolutely.
Oh, she's mad at me. Yeah. Oh, he's mad at me.
Yeah. So, but I think somebody said it earlier, it's about being their friend.
Yes.
We're so focused on being their friend
mm-hmm.
that we forget that we got to be their parents.
Yes. Right.
And at the end of the day, they're going to love you
yes.
for being their parent.
Absolutely.
When they get older and when they have kids, they will even appreciate
mm-hmm.
what you did even more because you're right. I've got three sons that I raised. My youngest is 29 and my eldest is 39. He'll be 40. But I raised my three sons.
Yes,
you know, I was a disciplinarian
yes.
with my sons. And I was still close to them.
Yes.
And they're my best friends. And they were my best friends throughout their growing up. But they respected me as their parent because I disciplined
yes.
them. Why? Because I loved them enough to not want harm to
yes.
come to them. And I understood
yes.
that
Absolutely.
If I don't discipline them and set rules in my home, when they become adults, they will not be disciplined enough to follow the laws
yes.
that are outside of my
yes.
home.
And I don't think order is a bad word.
No, it's not.
Order is not a bad word.
No, it's not.
Placing order in your home is not
it's
a
not.
Bad thing. And sometimes we think that
yeah.
it is a necessity,
yeah.
Keisha. And a lot of times we just want to drift away from
Absolutely.
That word order. And that's what
that's
why I placed order.
And then,
men,
what's the hardest thing? I mean, I have boys. I didn't have girls.
Mm-hmm.
It's difficult
right.
to raise boys because of the standard
yeah.
and because of what society. And I thank God and I praise God because I have three healthy, whole, positive black men that are functioning society, successful, and they're doing their thing, and they were still brought up and they were raised
right.
in a home, you know, with a mother and father.
Yes.
But I'm divorced now with my younger one.
Right.
You know, I was more of a single parent. But still, like you said, rules were put in place,
yes.
disciplines, and they were men and they respected me.
Absolutely.
And they didn't cross the line. Why? Because I set the line.
Right.
You know,
oh, yes.
I set the line and I set the tone. Same
but I think,
as
you with
your
I think you balanced well.
Yeah.
You know, even though you mentioned, you know, sometimes we come in and then the parenting of
mm-hmm.
co-parenting
yeah.
in some kind of way, it is interrupted sometimes.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
I'm going to say that.
Yes.
And
That's
so
good.
I think you did well with
mm-hmm.
balancing
mm-hmm.
to continue the balance
mm-hmm.
off. So even though their camera, you know, you mentioned, I think that he was raised
right.
with both parents up until his
right.
adult
he's a
year.
Teenager.
Absolutely. But you did well with balancing.
Yeah, absolutely.
You didn't allow
yeah.
an excuse
mm-hmm.
to come and say,
mm-hmm.
I no longer can parent
yeah.
as a mom because
yeah.
I don't have their father here.
Right.
Yes.
You took what you had and
yeah.
you made the best
yes,
quality
right.
life for your boys
right.
and you showed them what a strong woman looks
yes,
like.
Yes.
And so you didn't put meat in their hand and go,
right.
okay, raise, let this raise
yes,
you.
Raise
you. You took
right.
out the time to raise your children.
Right.
And a lot
yes,
of time
right.
we use media as a technology
yes.
as a babysitter.
Yes.
And we have to stop this.
Yes.
We have to stop
right.
and
mm-hmm.
say, hey, and take out the time to communicate. It's gotten so deep
mm-hmm.
with technology and media that I've heard that there are some families that actually text during the time
doing,
they're
yeah.
at home.
Mm-hmm.
So they're texting through communication.
Yeah.
And that's a different realm that we want to go into. And we utilize, instead of verbal communication, you use texting to communicate with our family.
There's no interacting.
There's no interacting. Yeah. And we're really destroying the form of how God made communication for us to bond together as a family. And I think that's very powerful. I think that every family should have a time where all technology is off.
I remember you went through that with your family.
Absolutely.
Before we'll pass, you guys would have the family night.
Absolutely.
All cell phones put up. Get a basket. Yeah. Get a basket and put that. Okay, when you come here, everybody put your cell phone in the basket, and we're going to sit down and we're going to talk.
Absolutely.
Right. We're going to have dinner. How about this? How about we sit down and have dinner together at a dinner table?
Absolutely.
You know? And how about we talk to each other?
Mm-hmm. But a lot of times kids can't do that because they see their parents. Exactly. It's hard for us to come up with cell phones.
It's true.
We
can't put I'm guilty.
Down. And what a lot of parents just doing that, putting the phones down and communicating with your child.
Right.
Your child is getting older.
Right.
They're learning a lot of different things. So what a lot of parents realize is their kids are forming ideas and ideologies of different things that you've never thought of.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So you got a chance to talk to them and say, whoa.
Wow.
Where you get that thought from?
Right.
Okay. You know, so it opens up.
So
and they're forming different character traits. And you're like, who is this? And the Bible talks about whatever you meditate on, be careful. Because, you know, you form that
That's
meditation.
Right.
So whatever it is that we meditate on all day long, we become that thing. And so,
so
when we see this on the phone with a child, and they become conducive to that, that is who they become.
That's
and girls try to emulate and mimic the things that they see and form from the cell phone.
That's right.
They change their dress
habits. Because of what they see. Because of all the marketing and everything that they see, and it's coming right across their face.
Absolutely.
It's a fantasy world.
Yes, it is.
This right here, it creates a fantasy world for your children.
Yes.
They can go on and be 30 years old if they're 15. You know, they can go on and be 19 if they're 11. So it creates a fantasy world for these girls.
Yeah.
And they, guess what? They have to now create a fantasy in their minds.
Right.
And that's what you begin to see play out in real life.
Yes,
it's a fantasy.
I formed at my home a time for Amber to be on the cell phone. It's a time. It's almost like you got to log in.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's a time. 2 hours, anything over that, there's a problem.
And
because
absolutely,
because I have absolutely access and I control.
Right.
Now I have the control back. We've lost the control with our kids because what's controlling the house is the cell phones.
Mm-hmm.
And we wonder why we don't have good communication with our kids. So-and-so don't have good communication.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's because you no longer communicate
with
you. Mm-hmm. If you take that phone, you will notice a different form of communication with your child. And you're able to build a good relationship with your child. Take the phone.
Mm-hmm.
Watch what happens. You can really get to know your child when you take the phone. So there's times now when, I hate to use the word force, but there's time now when we connect during the daytime and we form, we're building our relationship now because we're forced to connect.
That's right.
I hate to use that word, but that's what it is.
Yeah. And it's not easy in the beginning because, you know, anything, any type of change is going to be uncomfortable.
Right.
But as the parent, you got to be consistent
with
it. You know?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But the amazing part is, it's amazing what I have learned
from
her
through
taking the phone.
Yeah.
And you're thinking, building a relationship on a whole nother level.
Absolutely.
Well, what you can say, we're developing a friendship.
Yes.
Because now I have discipline in Makisha. I have discipline in Elder Kara. Now I can build a friendship.
Yes.
You cannot build a friendship without disciplining first.
Yeah.
And I think that's the thing we need to focus on. You
yeah.
say, how do I form this relationship with my child? Number one, discipline.
And take away distractions.
And I like what you said. They may not like it, but they don't always love you.
Right.
And Amber said that a long time ago. Mom, children want to be disciplined.
Absolutely.
Children want to be disciplined. Never forget she said that to me. Children want to be disciplined, Mom.
And for the parents that are sitting out there that are saying, oh, my child's not hooked on a cell phone like that, take it from them.
Yeah. Take it from them.
Take it from
watch
them for 24 hours and watch the behavior.
Yes.
If you want to know if your child is hooked on that cell phone, take it away from them for 24 hours and watch the behavior.
Yes,
absolutely.
Watch what you see.
Yes.
And you'll be able to see that. Then you're going to say, uh-oh, we got a problem here that we're going to have to control. Because what you're going to see is acting out.
Yes.
Because it's almost like a drug.
It is.
And any type of drug that you cannot get to, your body starts to go through detox.
Absolutely.
And your body starts acting out. It's the same thing. If this becomes a habit, if that phone becomes a habit and you take it away, they're going to start going through a detox and they're going to start acting out. That's going to just let you know where you are. Absolutely. Try that experiment just to find out where you are with your child and what has taken control of them. Then you will be able to see. And you pray and ask God to direct you on how to control it. And like Angie said, time it. Okay, you can have it during these hours for this one time. Okay, now let's put it away. Let's do something different. Let's have a conversation. Let's get your homework done. Go spend some time with your brother or sister. Whatever it is. But let's force some interaction. Yes,
because they want to communicate.
Absolutely.
Believe it or not, and I thought about this for a long time. Kids, girls especially. Mm-hmm. Girls love to communicate.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we need to realize, and when you no longer, watch this, parents, communicate with your daughters, they find someone to communicate with them.
Yes.
And I found out even when we had, you mentioned detox. Talk about detox. Mm-hmm. We detoxed here, right? So we had went through a rehab in my house. Okay? I know y'all, we went through a rehab. Okay? Take cell phone, you won't have it for 3 months. We went through a rehab.
Yeah.
Okay? What was interesting enough, because first of all, let's get used to not having it.
Right.
That's really important. Yeah. Once you get used to not having it, now I have to reprogram the mindset.
Yes.
And I'm just sharing some things that I did that worked for me.
Right.
Yes.
And we're talking about a 15, 16-year-old. Are you kidding me? Reform the mindset. Mm-hmm. Because now you need to understand, number one, it's a privilege.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because having a cell phone to some kids, they feel as though this is something like, you know,
it's a necessity.
It's
like
a need.
It's like breathing.
It's like breathing. It's a privilege. Wait a minute. And not only that, you got the iPhone better than mine.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
You got the phone better than mine. Right. I got the, you know, the Note 8. She's like, what is that? You got it. You don't even have a good phone.
Right.
I'm like, whoa.
Yes.
So they got stuff that's better than us. And let the truth be told.
And who's paying for it?
We're paying for it at our cost. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, we have not really thought about what we're handing down. And how it's interfering with a relationship. Because number one, I want to know your friends.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know who you interact with. I'm interested in knowing what type of homework you're doing. Mm-hmm. How your class is going. Wait, how do you like Miss So-and-so?
Yes.
What about your psych teacher? I want to know everything. Yes. Well, how do we know that? By forming a relationship with them. Well, we can't form a relationship with them because, right, Elder Carol, they don't have time for us.
Absolutely.
Because their whole life is what? Social media.
Yes.
So, rehab time. Rehab time.
Yeah.
And this is something I've done before many times, but this time it got real serious.
Yes.
And I just wanted to share this, and it was amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amazing, because now I don't hand it back because a weapon.
Mm-hmm.
This can destroy you. You give it back in increments.
Right.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay, you're really good. Because now you understand that this is something that is not a necessity.
Mm-hmm.
This is not a privilege.
Mm-hmm.
Guess what? This is an honor.
Yes.
And it's something that you need to appreciate.
Yes.
So if you want it for 2 hours, would you appreciate that or none? Emma was like, Mom, 2 hours is good. 2 hours is good.
Yeah.
I love the 2 hours.
Yeah.
You know, unless she was away from me or something like that. But when she's home, in my home, you do not need a cell phone in your hand.
Yeah.
Because that's the time when our relationship is born.
Yeah.
That's the time when I'm bonding with you, and that's the time when I get to know what's going on in your
life. That's
what I was going to say. So that's the key, and that's important.
Absolutely.
And it was amazing. She does the homework. I'm with her when she does her homework. I'm with her now. I'm finding about the best skills in gymnastics, what I'm weak in, what the strength is, and you know who's my best, who's the this, and Mom, what's happening, and this teacher's not. So I'm finding out everything because we're developing a relationship.
Yes.
I'm finding out what's going on in school the next day, and guess what? Usually, she would do the social media.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in the bathroom the other day, something so powerful happened. I was proud to share about this with you. And I don't know if I mentioned you, Keisha. It was so powerful. I was in the bathroom, and she was in the bathroom. I was in the bathroom, and I was straightening up the bed, and you know, she was getting ready for school in my bathroom. Please go in your bathroom. But I'm going to leave that alone.
Mm-hmm.
So she says, Mom. And I'm like, what? Now, usually, formerly, in the old ways we had, social media is there. She could possibly connect with her friend, asking them this question.
Mm-hmm.
I thought about this, but she asked me because I'm the available resource to her.
That's good.
And she says, Mom, why does girls become jealous? What is this about? And I said, well, and I started talking to her about it. And I was sharing, she said, I get it, Mom. She said, but we got to stop this. How do we just, this jealousy stuff with girls have to stop? Yeah. So right away that tells me something's going on with school.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
And she need to listen. I need to listen to her. What's going on with you, Andy? Yeah. And she began to share with me. And instantly the Lord began to show me, if you would not have taken that cell phone, her source of communication would have been through the friends to tell her or to, you know, kind of influence her to do something negative. She said, what happens, Mom? She's like, I never had a fight. What happens if girl is trying to fight you over nothing? Yeah. There's my form, not only communication with her, but there's my the gift of the right communication. Yeah,
absolutely.
And now we talked about it.
Yeah. Now you're aware of it.
And I'm aware of what's going on.
And you can guide her.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You can guide her.
And at the end of the conversation, it was so powerful, Ella Carol, because she was like, thanks. Yeah. Thanks, Mom. Does this make sense, Amy? Yeah. She said, it does.
Yeah.
And I said, focus. It is what it is.
Right.
Focus. And I was just giving her some of the strategies that she needs to use. And I'm telling her, she said, I got it. Yeah. I got it.
Mm-hmm.
And I stopped thinking. I think that's powerful. And we think about that right there, a void. And a few days later, I said, what's going on in the situation with the, you shared with me about the whole jealousy thing? She said, Mom, I did exactly what you said. Yeah. She said, it went away.
Mm-hmm.
See, she had that, and she mentioned, she said, Mom, when I get to school, they're like, it's telling me, you know, so-and-so don't like you, and you need, and I said, ignore it.
Mm-hmm.
See?
Get it out your ear. Yeah.
You see? Yeah. So there's a form of communication.
You don't have to respond to everything.
Absolutely. Yeah. Honestly, when I think about that, Keisha, if I wasn't available for her, that first line of communication would have been what?
Could have been someone.
That cell phone communicating with the friends, because it was not available for her, and she needed someone to communicate.
So instead of fanning the flames of the fire and making it grow, you know, you were able to throw some water on it, and
because
it dissipated.
She connected with me, and at that time, was her resource. And I think when we start thinking about that, and once again, was it easy? No, because at the end of the day. Listen, you don't have to like me to love me.
Yes.
I'm okay about that. And when you know you don't like me, it's like, oh, I'm doing a good job today.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It's like, none of my business. Oh, she has to call me and say, hello. My mom's truly tripping.
I'm like, she's doing a good job.
So we think about them like, oh, she don't like me today. I'm all right. Because I get it.
Yeah.
I get it.
Something else I wanted to mention, a lot of parents don't think about this. But when I think about this, I think about pedophiles. I think about a pedophile that's trying to get your 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, that's trying to get their attention. Now think about this. If I'm a pedophile, I get on these little sites, I connect with your child through this site. A lot of kids, what they're doing today now, they're living every aspect of their lives.
Right.
So they're actually inviting these pedophiles into the bedroom.
Wow, that's so true.
Just think about it. That's You're so 11,
true.
12, 13-year-old, whatever,
so
all the way up to 19 or whatever.
Wow.
You're 7. We have 7 5-year-olds that have these phones. They're inviting pedophiles into, we don't know if they're taking them in the bathroom with them.
The
kids don't know. They're innocent.
Right.
So I sit my phone up here and just take a shower and think that I just have Mindy and Sandy on the phone and we're all in 4th grade.
Right.
Hey, and I'm in the shower and I'm just having a conversation with them.
Right.
And what do we do today?
Absolutely.
And guess what? Mindy and Sharon, they're dudes. They're pedophiles.
They're 2 grown men.
And how could your child know? Your child don't know.
Yeah.
And that's something that's going on today. Kids are literally inviting pedophiles into your space.
Wow.
If you think about it, when you was coming up, your mom be like, don't open that door for anybody. We didn't have cell phones. But just think about how they kept everybody out.
Yeah.
I don't care who comes to the door, don't open that door. Call me. Get on the phone, the house phone. Call me if somebody comes to the door.
Yeah.
What are you doing? How do kids keep, how do you keep pedophiles out of the house? You can't. If your child has a cell phone and your child is too young to even think about this, just think about someone who's actually watching your child walking home from school, getting off the bus. We don't think about this stuff. But just think about if you have a guy that can lay eyes on your child and he's printing out pictures of your child that she's putting online. And now he's building this little, you know, this wall of images of your child. Now he can just log on and follow your child when she in the house and she in the kitchen.
Wow.
And she, hey,
that's powerful information.
And this person now, this is a sick person, but this is what I need parents to see. It's real.
Yeah.
These threats are real.
So let's talk about preventing that.
That's how we prevent.
How do we prevent?
Yeah, because I think that's really good information. Mm-hmm. Honestly, Let's talk about prevention.
Honestly, certain ages, they should not have access to any social media sites. Honestly, they should not. If you're not with them, honestly, cut it 110% because they cannot handle it. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Okay, Keisha, how do I get in contact with her? Okay, now we have some solutions. We have Verizon that just came out with a new watch. They have a watch where you can only program 4 phone numbers in this watch. You can dial them on this phone and speak to them through the phone. This is through Verizon. But there's another company you can Google. I do not have the name, but you can Google it. They also have a watch. You can get your child that's in elementary school, and you can dial them through this watch and communicate with them. Yeah. And it's a GPS track on the watch. There's no social media attached to this.
Yeah.
Now you go to 7-Eleven for the teenagers. Right. I don't know. Teenagers trip all the time.
Right.
And this is something that I use with raising my brother. I get the $9, $10 phone, the flip phone from 7-Eleven. There's no social media access on it. I just needed to communicate with him. Right. It's $10. Yeah. You're probably paying, I don't know, $12, $13 a month with the minutes, depending on how many minutes you need. And I was able to call him and communicate. Yeah, it's embarrassing for him, but I'm trying to save your life.
Absolutely.
And if someone come through the phone and kill your child, believe me when I tell you, you're going to wish you had put something in place and did something. So my question to the parents is your child worth it?
Yeah, what's more important?
Yeah, but is your child worth it? Not only that, because we can do that, and I'm in agreement with that, but to a certain amount of time, we know we have to release them to this very cruel criminal world and the people in the world that we're dealing with. Because I like the part what you say. I love doing that, but I deal with reality. Reality is when they get 18, they go off to college. Mm-hmm. And I love the educational piece. Because as yet we have so many young kids. Hey, listen, I have a 19-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they could be cruising the internet, checking out the scouting, you know, scouting around the internet, and not realizing that that may not be a girl on the other side of that phone.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, that educational piece is so important because we can kind of, you know, shun them away from the phone, keep that Apple, that Tepo, and all these Androids away from the kids where they do not have social media. And I am 100% agreement, but what happens when they get 19, 20 years old, when they leave out of our safe haven and have to enter in this very dysfunctional world?
This is what I'm saying. That's what, you don't, like, this is what I'm thinking. You're not locking them down from social media.
Mm-hmm.
You're thinking about kids when they first put a phone in their hand. They're elementary age.
Absolutely.
Right.
They cannot handle social media at all.
No, they don't need it. We talk about
it. We have a lot of parents out there that say, well, my child is in fourth, fifth grade. I need to get in contact with
them. Well, that, you know what I'm saying? Right.
Absolutely. So now from that point on, they still need to be educated because they still have access to phones.
Right, because they can use their friends' phones.
They can use their friends' phones. Right. So I think from elementary, they need to be educated. Even if some,
absolutely,
you have some parents out there that say, my child ain't even got no, they don't need a cell phone because I don't even want them connected to it.
Yes,
but
when they're over your friend's house, and they got their phone. Look, Tommy, mama don't have the same rules you do.
But I think we do not need to avoid the fact that our 19 and our 18-year-old young men and women, they need to sit them down. And I think that families, we need to have, I don't know, a mass media education, educational period at our home where we sit down once a week, honestly, take out the time if you have those teenagers in your home and talk about media issues.
Yeah.
And so these are some of the solutions that we can deal with.
Yes.
And we don't do that. We come home from work, we go in our room, they go in their room, and we don't know what's happening because literally you are building a demon, a beast. Is being transformed and being built in your home.
That's true.
We don't want to admit to that because this is we want to expose the enemy.
Yes.
So what if we have family time?
Yeah, that's okay. Parents, we go back to have family time.
At least 30 minutes a week.
Yes.
Talk about, do you know, discuss what's happening. Like you mentioned at the earlier of the show about a young man who was 17, 18 years old that didn't even realize. Maybe if someone would have educated him, elder care first, sat him down and talked about, you know, what
dangers,
is the negative and the dangers in having these cell phones and not being able to utilize them properly. Understand, stop trusting every system.
Yes, right.
You know, and I think that is a way that we can help, you know, save a lot of these youth lives.
Yeah.
We don't do it anymore.
It's just through education, just through sitting down, having the family time
once
a
week,
and allowing it to be a topic of conversation, because that's just the reality of what we're dealing with. And a lot of our 18 and 19 year olds are going to say, hey, I know about social media and all this stuff, but it's still educating. Did you know this happened? Did you know that?
You have a lot of those things
you call
us.
You have a lot of stages. Absolutely.
You have a lot of women and men that meet other people online.
Let me tell you something. I have a certain amount of Facebook friends, and I've noticed that lately. I have an influx of men that are befriending me. So a couple things have happened, and we know that through social media, people can take your picture or whatever and send out new requests, and it's not you. So I'm smart to that, and I'm getting a lot. One thing I do not do, first of all, I have social media as a platform for my ministry, for Sister Empowering Sisters, through empowerment, through motivation, and different things like that. I don't have social media and Facebook to meet people. So anytime, and this is happening a lot lately, anytime I say yes to a friend request, the first thing they do is inbox me. Hi, how are you doing? First of all, if that's you, I never answer them. I'm never going to say fine. I don't have a conversation with you. So I ignore that.
Shut it down.
I shut that down because my thinking is, okay, I just accepted it. Now you're asking me how I'm doing. Now you're trying to open up a dialogue, a conversation. That's not why I'm in social media. So I don't respond to those, because you don't know who's behind the scene doing that. That could be someone that has taken over somebody's page. I don't know. And it's happening so much. It's almost like it's the same person that has gotten a hold of, it's about the last 25 or 30 friend requests that I've received. So we, like you said, as adults, we've got to be smart enough to know that's not what I'm in social media for.
Ella Carol, when you think about it, why are we so shocked that our children can't handle it because adults can?
That's true.
So we think about it, and it's so funny to me, you know, when I hear the parent go, well, when they find out what the child is doing, the first thing you want to do, you know, you want to discipline them. I'm going to spank them. I'm going to do this. Why? Why? You gave them a weapon. You did not teach. No, they're supposed to. No.
Educate them. That's right.
Don't hand them that. That's and not expect for them to exactly what children do.
That's right.
And that's, you mentioned it.
That's right.
It's just because you're wise enough, Elder Kara, and you're mature enough to handle it. But you're mature enough to handle it. Why do we expect for children
to be able to
think, process, to be like an adult? Why did you go on that site? Come on. Give me a break.
Because
when you're dealing with accountability piece, the first level of accountability is us.
That's right.
We have to be accountable for what we put in our children's
hands. Right.
And we can't expect for a child to brain cells to be formed like an adult. Child is only going to do quiche what a child's supposed to do.
And you cannot hold anyone. I do this on my job, and we got to do this in our personal lives as well. You cannot hold anybody accountable for anything if you have not first laid down the ground rules. If you have not put the expectations out there. If you have not explained it thoroughly, you cannot hold them accountable for that.
Absolutely.
Because you did not make it plain.
After they
now,
get
if
a spanking,
you gave it to them,
after they get a spanking, somebody need to turn around and spank you.
Them accountable. But if you just take that phone and put it in their hand and say, happy birthday, here's the brand new, you know, phone that I gave you. They didn't have a phone. Okay, you're going to have a phone now because all your friends have a phone. Here you go. And you turn and walk away. And when they start doing things, you can't discipline them.
You're surprised.
You're surprised. Why are you surprised? It happens to you. You tell me people don't try to contact you that you don't know on a phone, on social media. You telling me they don't reach out to you? Sure they do, because they reach out to me.
And you accept the friend request.
I accept the friend request, but I know not to go any further.
Because of your maturity.
Absolutely. But I cannot expect my teenager to be on the same level and their brain cells to be formulated as much as mine, and to say that might be a bad person behind that.
Absolutely. The Bible talks about that. when you're a child, you act like a child.
That's right.
You know, we speak like a child. We act like, but when you become an adult, you put away childish things.
Right.
So that means our mindset transforms when we become an adult. But when we're a child, we almost expect. We expect them to do what they're supposed
that's
to
right.
do.
That's
and
right.
that means to err and make all these mistakes and do these things. But when we become a to make sure that we have done our jobs as an adult.
Absolutely.
And then they turn around and then they find other means of, you know, technology may not be in your home.
Right.
Then you can say, wait a minute now.
That's right. And think about this. It's not just being mature and being wise. It's about the person's self-esteem.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I don't have low self-esteem. So I have no need to have to talk to all these people. Think about a teenager that has low self-esteem. Like you said, that's being bullied.
Yes.
That don't feel like they're pretty enough.
Mm-hmm.
And all these people are befriending them.
Absolutely.
And then when they do, they want to talk. Hey, how are you doing today? Of course she's going to say, hey,
Absolutely.
I'm fine. That's somebody reaching out to me. That's a friend.
That's
somebody that's paying attention to me. And that's how a lot of, not just teenagers, that's how a lot of we women get.
Yes.
Like you said, they're adults that have been murdered
yes.
because people have befriended them on social media. I have an ex-employee that was an employee of mine that no longer works for me, but she still works for our company, that a few months ago, they buried her uncle, a 50-year-old male.
Mm-hmm.
The police traced it back. He was murdered in his home. When they found him, he was undressed, he was naked, and he was in bed. They traced it back through his phone and found out. He went on social media, and there was a new a person he had just started communicating with that he met that night. They caught them, and then they were laying in wait for him. This female, another female, and a male sought him out, and they went to his home to rob him. So the female was the one that got him in there. She went in first, and the other two, she let them in to rob him. He thinking,
getting
a little action from a female. I'm grown. She's grown.
And lost his life.
And lost his
life. He lost his life, guys.
His life.
So this is what's happening with social media. And if it's happening to adults because we don't see them coming, what do we think is happening with our children?
And let me ask you this. Imagine if he had some kids at home.
Exactly.
It could have been three bodies instead of one.
Absolutely.
So you don't realize you're bringing danger to the house.
Absolutely.
Not just you.
Absolutely.
It's everybody that's surrounded.
Everyone that's in
there.
But that's what's happening. This is what social media is doing.
Yes.
We have to wake up.
Yes.
And
yes.
we've got to be smart enough. Go back to the old time way. You know, all of this, and listen, I'm just going to put it out there. It's just me. Internet dating and all of this stuff, you better be careful with this stuff, because you don't know who is behind that photo. And not only that, it could be the same person, but you don't know the motive that's behind that person. We've got to go back to the old days. We got to go back. Let me tell you something. Let your friend set you up with a blind date. At least, guess what? At least she know him or he knows her or whatever. That's someone that knows someone.
Yeah. I'd just like to put this out there for parents that are seeking a site or some information, some stories, some real life things that are going on. You can go on YouTube and just put in Web of Lies.
Ooh,
and you will be able to tap into real life stories that are going on that involves men, like you say, men being set up, females being set up, as well as children.
Right.
So if that's just a free source you can go to, you know, tonight and have a conversation with your child. That's just a free source that will begin to start the conversation of things that we can do. And now you're putting the stuff in front of them to say, whoa, I remember what happened to that.
I'm not a fan. I've never been a fan of meeting people on social media. That's just me. Because, listen, I have a platform. I go to work every day. I go to church. If I can't meet someone in one of those places where I can see them face to face, then I don't need to meet them.
Mm-hmm.
Social media has become dangerous.
Yes, absolutely.
And our children are on social media with Snapchat, you know, Instagram, Facebook, all of these things.
Absolutely.
And these people have ulterior motives. Listen, parents, this is just education.
Yes.
You know, and parents, listen, it's not about being controlling because I want the power. It's about loving your child enough to know what's happening with them. I will never forget Columbine. I will never forget a lot of these things where children have taken guns into schools and have shot up everyone. Yes. People have lost their lives, and they had parents that did not know what was going on with them. Time out for you thinking that, hey, I can't go in Johnny's room because Johnny's saying, Mom, respect my privacy. Listen, that is in that bedroom is in my house, Johnny, okay? That bedroom is in my house. You ain't got no privacy in here. I love you, but no, 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 no. Parents, take your control back as being parents. Love your child enough to know what's going on with your child to save their lives.
And not being afraid to discipline your children.
Not being afraid, absolutely.
You know, fear is one of the things that truly becomes an enemy.
Yeah.
It becomes our number one enemy, is fear.
Yeah.
And it's important that we not fear, especially when it comes to raising our children and disciplining our kids. Listen, I'm a true believer that your child should have a relationship with you.
True.
And your child should be your friend. But I'm also a number one believer that number one, your first job is to be a parent.
Yes.
And so we came to you tonight to inform you, to empower you, but inspire you to be a parent.
Yes.
Not only to be a parent, but take out the time to discipline your children, develop a relationship with your child. Yeah. Don't be afraid to remove the media.
Yes.
Remove the technology from them.
Yeah.
Because
absolutely.
The technology truly has really handicapped a relationship with you and your child.
Absolutely.
And so don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Listen, that's really important that we came to just bring awareness to you with truth.
Yes.
So we can get into your homes tonight so that we can empower you so that your mindset can think differently.
Yes.
It's time for us to take back.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And like you said earlier, you know, we've come to compel you to control social media in your home, or social media will control your home.
Yes.
It's one or the other. You cannot have it both ways. So you've got to take that control back. And that's all this is. And it's out of love and it's out of concern, because our hearts bleed because of what we see.
Yes.
Because guess what? We're tapped into social media. So like it or not, a lot of the negativity comes to us. We don't respond or react to it, but it still comes to us.
Yes.
So we are able to see what's out there.
That's
and
it.
We understand that the youth has been targeted by the enemy.
Oh,
why?
Yes.
Because the youth is that next generation. Because the enemy does not like unity. He doesn't like the unity in your home, between you and your child. He doesn't like the unity that's out there. And he definitely does not like our youth being able to get to a point where God is controlling them.
That's
because he has launched, the enemy has launched an all-out war against our youth through social media.
And it's not too late to take
it back. It's not too late to take it back.
Become your child's friend on Snapchat, Instagram.
Yes.
Every now and then, take their phone. Take a look at the photos that they're posting.
Yeah.
It might shock you.
Yeah.
Just take a look at some of the things that they're doing, some of the things that they're displaying.
Mm-hmm.
You have that right as a parent. Even as you stand on righteousness, you have that right. Nikisha, what are some of the few things that you would like to just share with the parents before we leave?
I think that you guys should just pay attention to what you're giving to them and who they're connected to. First is just educating. I just got to stay on that. If we can just educate our girls to make better choices, because some of them will be attached to phones through other people, even if they don't.
Mm-hmm.
So number one for me is just education. When we educate them, they can start to make decisions on their own, you know, without the parent being, you know, stuck to their side. But number one is just to educate, educate, educate.
Yeah.
Because they can, when we educate them, then they can say, I know what I
can
do now.
That's fine.
Now I have choice. Some of them, they have no choice. So
when
they receive an invite, they have no choice because they don't know anything
else.
That's good.
You know, so number one is just educate. Yeah. We just need to educate our girls.
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely. With me, it's about awareness.
Mm-hmm.
Be aware of the surroundings in your home.
Mm-hmm.
Be aware of the weapons, you know. Be aware of the enemy that we have allowed to come in. Because if we're not aware of what's going on, what is it saying? If we don't know, we don't know.
Yes.
But be aware so that now that you know, what are you going to do? The most powerful thing that you can have is acknowledgement.
Yes.
Because when you acknowledge something, then you can begin to change it.
Yes.
But if you don't acknowledge it, if you're not aware, you cannot acknowledge it. If you don't acknowledge it, you can't change it. So what I would like to say to the parents out there today is that be aware. Don't put your head in the sand like an ostrich. Take your head out of the sand. Don't be afraid to look around you and see what's happening in your own space.
Yes.
And once you do, acknowledge it and then set a plan to make change.
Yes.
Where change is needed.
Yes. You heard it here.
Absolutely.
You heard it first line. Educate, aware, and minds take authority.
Absolutely.
According to Luke 10:19, the Bible says that he's given us the power and authority to trample over any demon. You have the power and authority as a parent. So this is a time that you take your authority and don't be afraid to discipline your child.
Mm-hmm.
And so we encourage you today, as you walk into this season that you're in right now, take that authority that God has given you and take back everything that the enemy has made an attempt to steal from us, starting at IU. God bless each and every one of you. Thank you so much for tuning in.
God bless you all.
Seeing you in the next 2 weeks.
Yes.
God bless.